I guess most of the Muslims who come here, I realize that they open debate with people, or they talk to people,
right,
and they advise people in a way to bring them to the truth. Mm-hmm. And the truth is, from the Bible and from the Quran, that the Lord our God is one. Do the will of God by worshiping God, submitting to Him, repent, and stay away from the evil, satanic doing, and stick to what pleases God. And this is the message.
Yeah, but
in general.
Right, but then, so I'm just wondering. So why is it, since the at least the majority of Christians will try to do a similar thing here as what happens in their churches? So why don't we see more Muslims? Like, why don't some imams turn up and do like preaching from the Quran?
I don't know.
Right.
It depends about the imam. Mm. I guess most who come here, they might have a lot of knowledge about Christianity, because when they come here, they meet more Christians than Muslims, because Muslims, they go to the mosque and they follow the preaching in the mosque during Friday or whatever.
Yes.
But here, the da'wah, the invitation is for non-Muslim about Islam. And the Christian who come over here, actually they come to dent Islam and to dent what Quran teach. And
there's those ones, but you know, like when your prophet was in Mecca, at the beginning, before he was exiled to Medina, he was preaching from the Quran, wasn't he? And he was preaching to unbelievers. So then, why don't Muslims do what your prophet did do?
I guess those people like myself, I come here, I try to talk to as many as possible, whoever talk to me.
Oh,
know, but the imam, most of the imam, maybe they are busy with their own family. They don't want, I don't think a lot of people, they like to come and start talking to people, you know?
Yeah, but remember, but that's the problem that your prophet had at the beginning. So he got people to believe in Islam by going out and preaching in adverse circumstances, didn't he?
That
means
there are some places, there's people, they call it da'wah people, they go and 5-6 of them or no matter, and they go to places and preach about
Islam. I've seen that. I actually spoke to like a couple of guys who go to Brixton.
But
this is where like the problem stems from. Is that is one of them that asked this question, because they're there at the da'wah stand, and all I hear him saying is about, oh, Jesus in the Bible, and I'm thinking he's holding a Bible in his hands, and when I look at him doing that, I'm thinking, what's that got to do with his prophet and Islam? Because your prophet definitely did not do that in Mecca, did he?
No, he didn't.
Because
the prophet chose war for the Meccans. The Meccans was idol worshipper, and they weren't Christian. But the prophet, peace upon him, even as the Quran talk about Christianity, about the doctrine of Christianity, and correcting. So the prophet, peace upon him, he had spoken with a non-idolater, those people who pagan. He spoke to Christian, he spoke to Jew, and
don't you think though that it is, because we know that when it comes to Christians, because of what, obviously they're following what Jesus and the apostles did, and this is something which would have happened since the apostles were around, where, and then it's carried on. It's carried on until now. So what I don't understand is, well, maybe I do understand it, but I suppose I more want you to, I would just more want your opinion on it, of why do we have this like inconsistency in the beginnings of, you know, what you compare Islam to Christianity, the Christians. the fact that the Christians consistently carried on what they were, the beginning people did, i.e. go out and preach. But yet the Muslims, they don't, the Muslims have actually switched. So I'm wondering why has that switch happened? Because obviously, Muslims like to say about how Islam is the fastest growing religion. But the thing about it is that, are they actually teaching the right religion, since they're now actually doing it different from the Prophet?
What they are teaching and trying to bring people to worship one God and to submit to the one God is the same apply for all the prophet and messenger. And when people, Muslim, haven't spoken about the Bible, what it preached, that's why, like myself,
yeah.
You know, if you open this book, it's all, most of it are not from the Bible, confirming that our Lord is one Lord, and this is the same teaching of Christ. I'm not going to come to Christian people and tell them the Prophet Muhammad says that, and they don't even follow in their own Prophet Jesus, peace upon him.
Yeah, but you do realize though that when the Christians started out, that's what they had to do. They were speaking to people who didn't know anything about, so they literally had to start from scratch.
Yeah, fair enough.
So then why is... Yeah,
fair enough.
Yeah.
You know, I don't have any more. I said my opinion about it. That's it. And people, they have a choice. People do according to the way they see it fit to spread. And the Prophet, peace upon him, said, بَلُّغُ عَنِّي وَلَا وَيَا. Tell about me even one verse of the Quran, like spread the word of the Quran. And this is why we say to people that, you know, God is one God. He's...
Right. Okay, but so... If someone came and told you that... Oh, what's going on? Yeah, that the reason why this inconsistency seems to have happened is actually because of a Muslim scholar, would you believe it?
What my opinion is, it depends about people, whatever they want. And consistency, it depends, I don't know.
All right, because I'm just going to read you something. This is talking about a Muslim scholar called Ibn Hazm, and he's from the ruling hierarchy of the Umayyad government in Cordoba, Spain.
Okay.
And it says that charged that the Bible had been corrupted and the Bible falsified. This charge was to defend Islam against Christianity, because Ibn Hazm came upon differences and contradictions between the Bible and the Quran. Believing by faith that the Quran was true, the Bible must then be false. He said, since the Quran must be true, it must be the conflicting gospel texts that are false. But present texts must have been falsified by Christians after the time of Muhammad. Well, actually, that's because this is a book that's written by something Niels. What's his name? Yeah, it's written by... Yeah. So apparently this Ibn Hazm, it seems like he's the one, Gerhard Niels, so he's written a book about it, and the article is called Why Do Muslims Believe That the Text of the Bible Has Been Corrupted? So what is...
Because in the same Bible we can read contradiction and more contradiction, and which bring confusion. It become like a circus, double messages, and mislead people instead of bring them to the right way.
Right, but
like I give you an example, and the same, and the Old Testament where it say that no one is able to see God, and the New Testament or the Old Testament at the same time, they tell you that Moses spoke to God face to face, and they are like friends, and you know, and the same token that how can you say nobody can see God and live, then people see God and they live.
No, no, because so
this is one of the confusion. For example, in the same time, all the prophet and messengers, they teach the Lord our God is one, then come with a New Testament, go and baptize in the name of the Father and the name of the Son and the name of the Holy Spirit, bring in Trinity into the doctrine. What's it about?
But here's the interesting.
The greatest commandment is the Lord our God is one.
Yeah.
We see there's confusion leaking in mislead those people who are normal people, and they cannot, you know.
But here's the thing. So you know what you said there.
Yeah.
I was just going to say that with the, you know, you said about not seeing God's face.
Yeah.
That's actually explained in Exodus anyway.
Because
he showed his hindquarters, and he said that he couldn't see his face actually in Exodus. But what I was going to say though is that what you said there, would that have been relevant in the time of your prophet? Because remember, the Christians would have been in the minority in that region.
The prophet, peace upon him, he never claimed that he have seen God.
No. No. That's not what I mean. What I mean is actually, If only the minority of people in the region at the time of your prophet and his companions were Christians, then they wouldn't actually be concerned about whether the Bible's corrupt or not. They'd be concerned about pushing Islam and preaching the Quran.
Yeah, and you're right, in Mecca and in Medina. Who would be concerned? Who would be concerned? The Christian, wherever they are, and the Christian will—they being scattered all around, and there is a Jew. So this is why the Quran contain and talk about the other scripture like Torah and Injil and what's in it, and try to correct it and try to warn the people of the book not to excess and their religion and stick to what God allowed his prophet and messenger to teach.
Right.
As a warner and as a glad tidings for those people who choose to obey, and warner for those people who choose to disobey.
Yeah,
this is my
input. I can understand that, but I was just saying that if it's at the time of your prophet, it would have been inefficient for him to go after Christians if they're not the majority.
The prophet, peace upon him, he wasn't going after any kind of group.
He was
preaching to everyone,
right,
including the Christian and the Jew. So he didn't specify that I'm coming to this people or this people. And we see that from the Sira, that once he went from Mecca to Taif. It's like 80 kilometers away. Walking, go there, and he start to preach to them. And they start to beat him, and he run away from them.
Right.
And that's the way it is.
So then, if we're going to go by that about what your prophet did and his companions did, and then now how Islam is now, where there's so much put into attacking the Bible, doesn't that mean that the scholars have actually subverted Islam? Because now the scholars...
I don't know. I don't know. What I'm saying is, they are not the one who's bashing the Bible. They are bashing it, and we have, to be honest, we have the right to bash it, as they try to bash our Quran and our Prophet, and try to find even... and hadith something offensive for the prophet.
But that's an even better one. You know, when it comes to, you know, you're saying about people bashing like the Quran and the and your prophet.
Yeah.
You know the hadith.
Yeah.
And even the Quran first.
Yeah.
Wasn't it only translated in other languages like very recently, and the hadiths were only translated back in 80 something, weren't they? So that means they were in Arabic for most majority of the time. But yet the Bible would have been translated a lot earlier. Doesn't that then mean that it has to be the Muslims who started bashing the Bible first? Just because of translation?
I don't know. I don't know. I cannot answer that. We believe that God revealed the Torah, the Bible revealed the Quran.
Mm.
While God preserved the Quran as it is in Arabic, the translation is being translated to many. The same happened with the Bible and the Quran, as it is the last revelation from God, and we can see there's no other book coming after it. And we believe that is the truth, and that's why it talked about the previous, which the people of the book add, insert, and omit whatever they like, and that's why you find 400 different version of the Bible in all languages.
Yeah. So what I'm really trying to maybe say, rather.
I want to drink. I finish the talk.
Yeah. All right. Right. So
that's it.
Yeah. So what I was trying to sort of more of a statement than a question is, shouldn't then Muslims take back like the true Islam dawah, like how your prophet and his companions did, and more push the Quran and ease off from bashing the Bible, since it must have been the Muslims who started it due to the translations. Because the Quran was in Arabic for the majority of its time, so the Europeans couldn't even read it anyway, so they wouldn't have had the chance to bash it. While this Ibn Hazm guy was about in 1064, so he knew Spanish and could get a Spanish Bible, so he would have started his attack on the Bible back in 1064, and yet the Christians would have responded like years later. Okay. Because they wouldn't have known the Arabic.
What do you expect from somebody who have and believe that he have the true guide for a human being to do, when there is another book being claimed that it is holy book and contain and divert you away from the truth?
Then all you do,
it's not our duty to show for people what's right, what's wrong, so people can use their intellect and believe and obey or reject and disobey.
Oh yeah, there's
this
that.
This is how life goes.
Yeah, but here's the thing. You know, when it comes to normal life,
yeah.
You know the reason why people do advertising.
Yeah.
Yeah, and a lot of those adverts, do you think a lot of them are just talking nonsense? Well, they will say some things about their products, which obviously is not a lie, but it's not really true either.
Even if
Coca-Cola.
Even if people saying false or nonsense, whatever, it's up to the receiver to use his intellect and choose which to believe and which to reject.
Yeah.
You know, because if you don't. If you have two statements from two different people, you read this one and you read this one, then you, according to your understanding, you would reject or accept either of them as a true or false. And that's the way it is.
Right.
You know, people, curiosity leads them sometimes to find out the truth without even realizing that they are seeking the truth.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is, take an example like Coca-Cola, that's what I was going to use. they could put big adverts like billboards everywhere, and they're getting you to buy a drink that rots your teeth, but people love it because of all the adverts and people buying it because it's everywhere to sell. So if Islam, rather than attacking the Bible, they just put billboards up of the Quran and pushed it with adverts, then they wouldn't even need to attack the Bible, would they? Because they would then have the strength of the numbers.
It depends on the Muslim who they are talking to. So if I'm talking with a Muslim, I'm not going to bash the Bible to prove that Islam is right, because I will say the Quran. If I'm talking to a Christian, I'm not going to tell him, look, my Quran say so and so and so and so. Even I'm going to include my speech from the Quran, but I will show him, and this is what I do. I will show him the truth and the Bible, confirmed by the truth and the Quran, to at least bring him to understand that there's common and there's differences between two books, and the book which guide you to the right way is not the one who have mixed messages about the same topic. You got my point?
Yeah, so that means then, since the Quran is clear, and you feel the Quran is superior to the Bible.
I do.
Right, so that's fine. So that means, since that's what you feel, you wouldn't have to actually use the Bible at all, isn't it? You can just go and convince them just with the Quran, since you feel it's superior.
No, because the Christian, if I come towards them and I talk to them only about the Quran, they may say, no, but this is contradict what the Bible is teaching. So I choose the teaching of Christ through the Bible to show them that the common between the Quran and the Bible is the truth. And this way, they cannot tell me, no, your Quran is wrong then, because I'm showing them from their own Bible. So they cannot deny their own Bible, unless they want to deny both then.
Right, do you think...
You got the point.
Yeah, I know that, but do you really think that the majority of Christians study their Bible?
No.
Yeah, so therefore you don't really, can just push the Quran, isn't it?
But most of the Christian, the Bible is, if you open the Bible is that thick. For people to go and to read and read and read and read, it is too long, you know?
Yeah, so therefore, that's why you can push the superiority of the Quran to the majority who haven't studied.
Let's use what you know. What I have done myself. I read the whole Bible.
Yeah.
From page 1 to page.
It varies.
6,000. Then I read the Quran, and then I put note down. What's common, what's differences. And this is the way I follow to resume and to get to resume of the two book what the truth is. And that's the way everybody should reflect upon what I'm saying, because if you're seeking the truth, you need to give yourself the space to read both of them.
Right, so when we look, you know, we see that obviously there are a lot of Christians and some of them study their Bible. So then what about the Hindus and Buddhists? So how come...
I have no idea about Hindu and Buddhists.
Yes, right, so...
Because I'm not that mixed with them, so I have nothing, no knowledge of it.
Yes, yeah, so
something out of my knowledge I don't talk about.
Right, so but then with the amount of Indians that there are, and Chinese who do the Buddhism, then there should be like a Dawa, like script as they call it, for them as well, shouldn't there? Well, why do it only have to be the Bible?
I don't know.
But that's what I'm trying to say about this Ibn Hazm, that it's like the scholars have subverted Islam and drawn them away from the original way of doing Dawa.
I guess you're wrong, because as I mentioned, there is some people, they are going to do dawah for numerous people, and the other day I come across one guy he's Muslim, he lived and for 20 years in Japan, and he managed to bring almost more than 100,000 Japanese into Islam.
Right.
So this is how people make da'wah.
Yeah, so that proves that you don't have to attack the Bible then. So that means...
In Japan, he wouldn't attack the Bible that's because they have nothing to do with the Bible.
That's what I'm saying, but the majority of people over here is the same as well.
But what do you want from me?
Huh?
What do you want from me?
No, I'm trying to tell...
Why you make it too hard for me?
No.
You go around and the same topic. I don't know.
Yeah, because I'm trying to show that the da'wah has been subverted.
Tell to the people of da'wah, I'm doing my best, the way I explain to you, and that's the way I do it. And I don't know, it seems there's another problem with Hatun and with the police.
Again? But she seems... Well, she seemed quite peaceful today, so I don't know what the problem is.
Peaceful? She's never peaceful.
No, but I didn't hear her screaming like usual.
As if he was screaming.
Yeah. Anyway. But what I was just trying to say is that...
Don't come back to the same subject, forget.
Finish. It sounds to me like there's something dodgy going on there.
Well...
Well, the fact that you don't want to admit that, it looks as if... these scholars are like diverting da'wah in their own onto their own agenda away from the Quran. That's what it sounds like to me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah.
I explain the way I'm able to explain. Forgive me if I said anything offensive.
No, that's fine.
And
yeah. Well, you want to find out what's up with her?
Let's go.
Israelites will return to take down Islam.